I want to show you all something awesome. This is a leaf of Ficus Racemosa, which I collected from a big tree on the roadside. And I will show you what the awesome thing about this is. Ta-da! This has rooted. Can you see this? So I plucked this leaf from the tree and just put it into water, and it rooted in around 18 days. 1-8. Look at these awesome roots. So there is no stem, there is no node. It's just a leaf stalk. And the reason I'm getting this kind of a density is because I've been pruning it often. So almost every alternate day I just prune the root tips, making sure it remains in that circumference. The moment it starts touching the inner walls of the glass, I cut it off. I cut the root tips. And that's how this density has happened. So a lot of people ask, or they're confused whether air pruning works or not. Don't think about pruning by air, just think about it as root pruning. The fact that I keep pruning this to get a higher density of roots is the same thing in air pruning. Instead of there manually pruning the roots, it is the air that is killing the roots and increasing the density. Now the funny thing is, this part is getting dark and it's dying, I don't know why. Now the question is, why is this rooting? There is no node, so there is no way this will survive after the leaf has died. At least that is what I'm thinking. I don't think there will be a new shoot or a new leaf sprouting from this. So once this leaf dies, this whole thing will die. But that makes me think, why have rooting in the first place? If the leaf is not going to produce a stem or a new leaf, then why go through this rooting process at all? Why have this technology built in? If any of you know the answers, please let me know why this rooted in the first place, and will I lose this completely? Will the leaf die and not produce a stem or a leaf? I hate to lose this, but it's so fantastic. I just love these roots. And if I had not pruned this on a regular basis, I would just have two or three roots growing long and going around in circles in the glass. So root pruning really helped in making this very dense and compact. I hate to lose this. I wish a new leaf sprouts over here. So this can be a nice mini bonsai. I'm okay to lose this much, and I'll just put it in a small pot. This is called surface roots or nebari. You know, people growing big bonsai, they would die to get something like this. And this was so easy. So I took it, this leaf is now, it was taken about exactly 40 days ago. And it rooted in 18 days. So today is the 40th day. I think this black spot is going to spread, and pretty soon the leaf is going to die. But I still hope this part remains alive and produces a new leaf somewhere here. Otherwise, you know, the rooting is just a waste of time. Why go through this process at all? But it's an interesting experiment. I haven't seen anything like this on the internet. When I did search, I came across one leaf of a banyan tree, which I had mistakenly thought it had grown roots from the stalk. But on checking it later, I realized after this was rooted, I checked and I found that they had a tiny bit of the stem, and hence a node was available. So it was a big leaf with a tiny stem, and that had rooted. But I had, in my hurry, misunderstood that as the stalk of the leaf. So in their case, when the leaf dies, they still have a stem to survive. They still have a plant. But in my case, this is just a leaf. And if this goes completely, I have nothing except a successful rooting experiment of a leaf. Okay. So this is Ficus Racemosa. It's a collected specimen and it's about 1 year old in this pot. It has been pruned several times, repotted once. And I had taken this leaf to show the merely to show the reduction in leaf size which I have achieved in 1 year's time. So this is how an adult leaf looks like, a leaf from a big tree on the roadside. So look at the size difference. And the same cuttings, these cuttings were taken from this plant, and look how tiny these leaves are. These are even tinier than the parent.